I was enrolled in 1945, and I know that my father took tremendous guff from his co-workers for educating a girl. What's wrong with you, man? But I wanted to be an educated person. I wanted to know lots of things. And this was the place where you went to get that. And when I went to school, my parents had $400 in their bank account. That's all the money they had in the world. And they opened an account in Athens for me and gave me that $400. And boy, if that wasn't a sacred trust, you better believe it. And I still remember that at one point there was a sale of women's clothing, and they had a black princess style winter coat for $15. And I thought my mother would love this. She hasn't had a new coat in years. And I bought it using some of that $400 with great trepidation. But the coat fit beautifully. My mother loved it. My father didn't mind, and he said, it's all right. So it was a big success. I could breathe easily after that. When you went into Cutler Hall, you went up on the second floor, I do believe, and there was a little door, and there was literally a ladder, a wooden ladder that you climbed up. And the little keyboard was maybe about 18 inches long, and it was just a little tiny thing under the eaves, way up in the tower. Obviously, nobody had been up there with a dust rag for years and years and years. So it was kind of spooky for that reason. I didn't know what was going to be up there. Always the alma mater, and depending when the season was, some hymns. And I was, as it was another one of those new things, and I wasn't sure what was involved. Nobody took me by the hand and said, you go up the ladder, and this is where it is, this is what is expected that you do. It was sort of, okay, there it is, go. But once, okay, here's the keyboard, this is what I have to do, and you did it, and it was okay. And that was the routine. Nobody else was there. Nobody checked on me. I was very independent. And this was something that you could do. And you fit in this place, and you went and you did it. It's kind of like duty, but at the same time, a pleasant one. The one thing that I did think at the time, and that I remembered in years after, was the calm feeling that one got in the main part of the campus when you walked under all of those trees on those brick sidewalks. That was a wonderful place to be. It made you feel so good. You have a sense of place. When one is interested in plays music, you kind of go into a different world that is so satisfying. Playing the piano was always a constant in my life. This was as native as talking or walking or anything else that one did. You did music. It's like the fingers of your hand. You know, there's one out here that says piano. People can do things that they think that they can't do. And that's all it takes, is education and somebody to needle you a little bit.